August is National Breastfeeding Month, the time doctors use to highlight the benefits of breastfeeding both for babies and mothers. Touro Family Medicine physician Dr. Meredith Maxwell joins us this morning to talk about how those benefits have grown amid the pandemic. Hi, Dr. Maxwell. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, so first I want to talk about, you know, there's been some talk from women saying, I don't know if I should get the vaccine, I'm breastfeeding. But can you explain how, you know, actually getting the vaccine right now is beneficial for your baby if you're breastfeeding?
Exactly. There has been some studies that shown that the mRNA COVID vaccine produces antibodies that are passed through the breast milk to your child. So your child actually benefits from that protection when you have that vaccine on board and then you breastfeed. So even more of a reason to go out and get it if you're a breastfeeding mother, to pass that protection on to your child.
Right. Think of how vulnerable little babies are to begin with and how, you know, easily they can get sick. And that's just an extra layer to protect them from COVID-19.
Exactly, not to mention other antibodies that you've been exposed to throughout your life that you're passing on to them. So I think breastfeeding is one of the best benefits that you can give your child in a protection sense from the outside world.
Absolutely. You know, we've heard, a lot of people have heard, you know, breastfeeding helps you lose weight after you have the baby. Something people might not know, that breastfeeding can also reduce a woman's risk for type 2 diabetes and other types of diseases. Can you explain that?
It does. So they have a decreased risk of ovarian and breast cancer in women who breastfeed. Also, it helps shrink the uterus after delivery, which is to help it return to normal size. It burns calories. You get back to your weight, your pre-pregnancy weight faster. It reduces a risk for type 2 diabetes, rheumatoid arthritis, cardiovascular disease. It can lower pressure and high cholesterol. And it also delays your period a little bit. So it extends the time between another baby if you're not on birth control at that time. So it does so many things, not only for yourself, but also for your baby. It can also lower the risk of SID, sudden infant death syndrome, which I know people are aware of. So the benefits are, they're numerous and plentiful. I would really encourage trying to breastfeed, and it's free. And it's always the right
That's always a good perk. You know, and it not only helps babies when they're young with sudden infant death syndrome, but also there are benefits for later in life for children who are breastfed.
Right. There are fewer long-term health problems when they grow up. These include like diabetes, obesity. They've seen that breastfed infants are less likely to get obese. So there are so many benefits that you can provide your baby long-term, even into adulthood, that you can give them through breastfeeding. So I think if you tried and failed, every baby is different. Every time is different. So don't feel like you can't try again if you weren't successful the first time.
All right, Dr. Maxwell, thank you for that advice this morning. We appreciate it.
Definitely.